Advanced body armor, drones, cyborgs. Is this the future of police? This is Trace for D News. Robocop is out in theaters, promising action and a crazy cool reimagining of the 1980s robotic future film set in Detroit. The old film had a lot of social commentary and represented a fear of turning over our safety to the dominion of robots. 30 years later, with robotics permeating more of our society than ever, the concern is still real and far closer to the surface. I mean, we may not be ready to put a man's head onto a machine's body, but we got a chance to talk to the cast of the new RoboCop to ask them why the idea of a robotic human hybrid is so compelling.
When do you stop being a human being and when are you a machine? I'm not talking about singularity, but if you like in the case of RoboCop, he's amputated from his throat down. The rest of his body is mechanic, and he also has artificial intelligence implants in his brain that control some of his decision making. We have to be careful of the consequences.
I just think that the idea of the combination of man and machine is a great, it's a sort of delicious cocktail.
The best free-roaming humanoid robot we've got now, according to the DARPA Robotics Challenge, is Schaft. The Japanese robot isn't as sexy as RoboCop, but it's designed to help with nuclear disasters, not to look good while battling on camera. Schaft doesn't inspire quite as much fear. It can drive a car, it can navigate rough terrain, it can remove debris, open doors, cut holes in walls, and manage a number of other dexterous tasks like hooking up hoses and turning on valves. All extremely valuable in disaster scenarios, but not exactly one of the scariest robots in the world. The new film deals with drone warfare too. In the year 2028, RoboCop is created by the multinational conglomerate Omnicorp as a way to circumvent a new law prohibiting drones from bearing firearms. As of today, private unmanned aerial vehicles that fly above 400 feet are still prohibited by the FAA, though there's a mandate for American airspace to open up to drones by September 30th, 2015. So far, filmmakers, Border Patrol, and police have made some basic use of domestic drones, but at the moment, they're still expensive and hard to find here at home. The US military, though, they have deployed 11,000 drones since 2002, and 50 countries have their own drone programs, including China, Israel, and Iran. We might be looking at a future without humans in the cockpit. Luckily for us, RoboCop is still safely in the realm of science fiction, but the technology is on the horizon. Drones can already fly, drive, run, and navigate disaster areas, but are we really that far off from a military robot soldier? Would we somehow be less afraid of cyborgs than straight-up robots?
There's always going to be a man behind the machine, behind the machine, behind the machine. So we can never take away the blame, we can never take away the shame, the guilt. There's never going to be a finger that's pointed nowhere.
As technology advances and predictions of the merging of man and machine looms, our laws, our police, and our citizenry are going to have to be rushing to keep up with the advance. So if something like RoboCop really existed and you came across him, how would you feel?
It's freaky to me. Yeah. As Gary, yeah. It would... I'd be very wary. I'd be a little unnerved by it.
What do you think? Is a human-robot hybrid the future? Release your paranoia down in the comments, and thanks a lot for watching DNews, everybody. Make sure you subscribe.